Hi guys, today we are taking a look at the now over 3 years old spring ecosphere. You can tell I'm late with this video because it's not actually spring anymore. Before we dive in, let's do a quick overview of what happened in the past 3 years to better understand the current events. When the ecosphere was first made, over 3 years ago, it was the home of two different plant species, Daphnia, copepods, ostracods, bladder snails, aquatic isopods and mites, tubifex worms and various insect larvae. A week later, it turned out that hydra, leeches and some kind of worm were also present. After 2 weeks, we found planaria as well. After 4 months, they had exploded in numbers and most of the Daphnia had died. After 5 months, the Ambulia plants were having a really hard time. After a year, the Ambulia, Daphnia and Tubifex, as well as the aquatic mites and copepods, had all gone extinct. After 2 years, the aquatic isopods, hydra and leeches had disappeared as well. The spring ecosphere was now the home of the Vallisneria, algae, bladder snails, ostracods, planaria, a strange small aquatic mite, and all remaining microbes. This is the closed ecosystem nowadays. The bladder snails are still present, roaming around in the jar and eating algae and detritus, while consuming oxygen, producing carbon dioxide, poop, and offspring. As you may know, bladder snails like to climb out of the water from time to time to hang out. So did this individual. It just so happens that a couple of ostracods are swimming about in the water the snail stores in its shell. Pretty neat. Something that has changed since last year is the fact that the water has gotten a bit of a brownish tint to it. It looks a bit like the color from a blackwater aquarium, which is caused by tannins released from peat, wood or leaves in the water. I am not completely sure why the water in this jar is slowly turning a bit brown, but it could very well be caused by decaying plants or algae. It looks like the plants are doing quite well though, so we'll keep a close eye on it and see how it develops in the future. In any case, I'm not really worried about it. Speaking of plants, the Vallisneria are still present and reproducing. Almost every single leaf has algae growing on it, giving it a bit of a hairy look. I can't get the image out of my head that these Vallisneria leaves are large stems of trees. The algae are the branches of the trees, and all the ostracods are birds flying through a large forest. That might sound like a strange association, but looking at the same jar filled with pond water and plants for years makes you say weird stuff sometimes. The Vallisneria are doing their job in this closed ecosystem as well. It consists mainly of taking carbon dioxide produced by the animals and bacteria and converting it into oxygen, which is used by those animals and bacteria. This particular Vallisneria is still very young and therefore hasn't any algae growing on it yet. I can't really tell whether or not this algae is doing well. It is clearly very abundant, but the color isn't great. If all this algae is starting to die off, it could explain the color of the water. It might have been growing so much that some of the algae is depriving other algae of light, which could kill it. All I can really tell you is that in a closed ecosystem of this age, new algae will certainly grow if there is an ecological need for it. And algae will start to disappear if there isn't an ecological need for it. For instance, when more plants are growing or more animals start dying. I'm not expecting too many radical changes in this ecosphere anymore though, because the ecosystem seems quite well balanced by now. We discussed the bladder snails earlier in the video and have also seen some ostracoles already. Here's some more little sea shrimp. What you haven't seen yet are the planaria, but fear not, they're still here as well. You might have noticed by now that not that much has really changed in this closed ecosystem since last year. And that's a good sign. I've talked about the loss of biodiversity in closed ecosystems in the previous update on this project. In a nutshell, a lot of biodiversity is lost in the earlier stages of an ecosphere, as the closed ecosystem is slowly developing into a well-balanced ecosystem. Once a closed ecosystem is balanced, not much will really change anymore, as there is no interaction with the outside world. It seems, at least at this point, like the spring ecosphere has indeed reached a steady equilibrium. The needs of all organisms are satisfied by other organisms in the closed little world. Barring any catastrophic events, there's no reason that should change anytime soon. I should mention that I haven't seen the tiny aquatic mite anymore since last year's video, but that doesn't necessarily mean it went extinct. So, this closed ecosystem has harbored life for over 3 years now. The past year, all plants, algae, snails, ostracoles, planaria, and microbes have been living their lives in the little world on my windowsill, without seeing much change. If all goes well, the spring ecosphere could live on indefinitely, perhaps just like it is now, or perhaps we will see a continuing loss of biodiversity in the future. I will make sure to keep you guys up to date. That's all for now. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.